Well, it looks like things are moving around out here at the old elementary school in Richmond, Saskatchewan. Let's see if we can see who's driving this thing. So, yeah, we followed Romana Didulo. And Romana has started taking over this school here. I don't know what's going on with this bus thing here. But looks like they're moving things around. There's no license plates on some of the vehicles out here, so I don't know if they're going to be able to really move off the property. But yeah, once again, we're out in Saskatchewan. It's Romana Didulo. It's like a cult. It's like a fake government thing. It's like a scam. They've taken some people for quite a lot of money, and they've told people not to pay their taxes and their utilities and their electric bills and all things of that nature. And yeah, quite a few people have fallen victim to it. I got tips recently from something that is called the Victims of Romana Didulo. It's a Telegram page, Telegram channel or group. So that's where I found out about the location today. And you've joined me here, Tall Bike Tommy from Community TV in Richmond, Saskatchewan, where I have discovered that this is the location of our Romana Didulo and her closest following. It seems like there's probably about 6 to 8 people that are sort of like have taken over this abandoned school here. From what I understand, a local person actually owns this. It's private property now. It's no longer owned by the county or the school board or anything like that. So it's just kind of a building. It does not appear to be like a habitable building, though, like a place that people could live. As I pointed out earlier, it has like boarded up doors and windows. It has power cords like running out of the doors onto the roof. It looks like they're using this bus to block the view of the main bus, the main RV, so that I can't get the shot anymore. But I already got the shot. I know where they're at, and I got the shot. I found them, and this is where they are. So yeah, like I said, gonna do a little bit more planning and recon and getting some shots, and thinking about my next move here. If you got something in the comment section you want to share, that's okay with me. I'm just gonna hop back in. It's a cool morning out here in the land of the living sky. Very cool morning. But thanks for joining us. Thanks for, well, me. I went out here solo mission. Out here with the old 96, 97, same. GMC Sierra. Drove it on out here to check things out here in Richmond, Saskatchewan. And looks like they're doing some recon. They're getting the shot. I'm getting the shot. So, zoom in and get the shot of them getting the shot of me. That's one of the ones I really like. Yeah, it's like a standoff type of move. Like, I get the shot of them getting the shot of me. I was actually concerned for like a second there that the big black RV could possibly be used as some kind of a battering ram to ram or disable my vehicle. But it turns out, looks like they were just sort of moving it around to get like a more secure, that's what they're doing. They're moving things around to get a nice secure barrier around the Queen's RV. I'm sure that this was probably ordered by the Queen. Go ahead and make a wall with vehicles to block the view of the camera. We don't want Tall Bike Tommy from Community TV getting the shot right now. We don't want him getting the shot of Romana Didulo. At the camera here, I'm doing some zoom shots. I'm getting the shots on them, so that, you know, we could just, you know, document that they are currently here. Let's see. I'm gonna switch the camera around and show you guys the live shot here. So when I first rolled up, I could clearly see the whole meet and greet Romana Didulo Kingdom of Queen of Canada, RV and accompanying car. There's like a vehicle as well. Just over the past few minutes here, they have sort of maneuvered the other big black RV and a smaller van here to, I guess, create a barrier, some kind of a physical barrier. They're like, back it right in, make sure that we got full coverage, and then maybe they're gonna pull trailer over or something. I don't know. It looks like they're coming for a little walk to have a look, see, maybe to find out different things, you know. But I'm not super interested in talking, you know, with them. Just isn't really my thing, you know. Not really my thing, big time. So I might kind of not, but I might so, but I might not, you know. But I might not, you know. So we'll get the shot though of the guy, you know, see what he's doing. Walk on the door just in case. He's probably gonna get my license plate, right? Get my license plate, right? Of course. Yeah. Don't do anything too funny. How's she going, bud? Yeah, just needed to get the license plate. Okay, bud. Like, what are you gonna do with that? You're gonna run it to the secret CIA, alien FBI, top secret government, bud? I am sorry, guys. I cannot take this seriously at all. Like, who takes this seriously? This is so crazy. It's like a cult that's been running around Canada since like the start of the pandemic, tricking people into thinking that this lady from the Philippines, who was like in a halfway house just about 4 years ago in BC, is now somehow the de facto queen of Canada, all deserving of our respect and honor and money. She wants lots of money. Geez, do they ever need your money for being the queen and having all kinds of secret access to resources and power? It just seems wild that they need your money so badly. And then they need people's RVs. They've taken RVs from people. It's just a lot of concern about the people that have fallen victim to this whole thing, whether you call it a scam or whether you call it a cult. It's taken lots of people. Some folks out there have even stopped paying their mortgages, their utilities, under the direction of the Queen Romana Didulo. Geraldine asks, what is happening? Can you explain? So I've come early morning from Medicine Hat out to, we are in Saskatchewan. We're right next to Fox Valley in a small town called Richmound. I'm not sure how it's pronounced. Don't often come out here or really know anybody around here. So I'm in Richmond, Saskatchewan. And there were some sightings and tips about this weird thing that's been going on in Canada called Queen Romana Didulo. Some people call it a cult. Some people call it a scam. Some people think it's a real thing. And that, to me, is ridiculous. It's so crazy. Thank you so much for everybody joining the live right now. Share this with folks. I know this was a story that was covered through Vice Media. I think CBC has covered it. CTV has covered it. It's national news, and it was a blip on the radar a few times over in Brampton, Ontario. These guys went over there to do some kind of a demonstration, and a guy was on the live video. He tried to arrest police officers, one of the followers of this organization, and I use the term loosely. This does not look very organized to me. But one of the followers of this thing, of this person, I'll get the shot here. One of the followers of that person on that banner right there, Romana Didulo, one of the followers tried to arrest police officers in Brampton, Ontario at a demonstration and was subsequently arrested himself, obviously, right? I mean, you know that, right? You know that you cannot arrest a police officer if you're just some guy. Like, that's not how that works. Okay, so they're moving the vehicles again. They've been doing sort of musical chairs here. I think it's the shot. They're worried about me getting the shot, right? Because, like, now they got the big black RV. I mean, this thing, wow, that's got to be their CIA vehicle right there, right? Starfleet One. So yeah, Romana Didulo, among many things, claims to be in touch with like aliens and the CIA and the secret government and QAnon, all of the QAnon stuff you can imagine. You know, they cherry pick all kinds of weird conspiracies. And right now, one of the big conspiracy things is floating around all through the conservative, ultra right wing stuff is that your kids are not safe in school. Oh my gosh, your kids, they're not even safe at school. They're being indoctrinated at school, right? I mean, I'm sure there's some parents that have very legitimate concerns for the things that go on at public schools. But just all of a sudden, it's become this big thing. You know, they get the Million March out there, which I discovered last night. They've decided it's no longer a march. They're not even marching. So it's like, okay, what is your thing? It's like, they say, we got hundreds... we got hundreds and thousands of people, not hundreds of thousands. They said hundreds and thousands of people for the Million March. Cause it was like Million Man March. And then it was Million Person March. Then it was hashtag Million March. Then it was Million March for Children. And, turns out the thing is like just a big pipe dream, looks like to me. I'm sure some folks will show up for some things, but, I don't know. Seems really weird to me. I'm going to head down to the baseball diamond in Medicine Hat that morning to check out what's going on with that. Kids are not safe in schools. What? I watched you from the get-go, man. Okay, yeah, if you think your kids are not safe in school, that's entirely your decision, right? I mean, you have the freedom to make the choices about where your kids go to school, right? If you don't think they're safe in the community that you're in, you can move on up to another community. You could take them in, homeschool them. You know, could probably couple options there. You know, there's internet-based solutions. There's like special private academies. There's all kinds of different ways, get kids into that academia, right? Learn them some science or whatever, mathematicians and whatnot. But yeah, I just find it really interesting that like, oh, it's just all of a sudden big back on the radar thing that like, sex ed's like dangerous, it's kind of obvious, you know, it's like, okay, now they're teaching things with the LGBTQ2S+, and there's just too many letters now, and why I can't expect the kids to go to school and learn all those letters at once. I mean, it's too much to ask, right? I'm being sarcastic. I don't know, what do you think about this whole thing with the Million March? Are you going on the Million March? Do you support it? Are you against it? There's been a lot of controversy surrounding it. Our MLA, Justin Wright, his wife was a member of the group since like late August, and that had been pointed out recently, and they got on that real quick, dispelling that. So, oh, nope, that's not something she's into. She's not an organizer, not something that they're involved in, you know. So, they're not exactly showing public support for it, but you better start doing a better job on reporting if you think kids are safe in school. I mean, all right, like, I guess if you're sending your kids to a school that you don't think is safe, you should be doing a better job at parenting? Like, I don't know. I mean, that's just my thoughts on that. I mean, you know, I'm from way back when, you know, turning 40 this year, so the sex ed I got in school is totally different, but I don't remember my parents really having any problem with it, and I learned gay stuff when I was in school, and then, you know, going to school and talking like 30 years ago, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, they taught the butt sex stuff in the schools where I was going to school. I mean, out in Halifax, of course, what the curriculum's been like out here in the prairies, but it's like not a new thing that they're teaching, kids about all different forms of the sexualities and stuff like that. You know, it's like, you know, the heterosexual is kind of the default teaching on pretty much all, you know, forms of, media and entertainment and that sort of thing. And then, you know, you got sometimes a little bit of something else. Oh, somebody coming over here with some kind of a truck, it looks like. Get a truck moving this way. Check out what's going on here. A truck coming on down the road. Find out what the heck going on with the truck over here now. And we will see. We will see. Howdy. Oh, there's a guy. Looks like a guy. He looks something fierce mad, though. Or is he something fierce mad, or did you want to talk, or? Oh, yeah. How's she going?
What are you doing?
I'm sitting in my truck.
Yeah, I see that. What are you doing here?
Oh, like, what am I doing
this
here? This part right here, I thought, was just like a public part. Like, I thought that orange line probably was the... Well, I just wanted to get past that first part. I mean, if you're kicking me off your land and this is your land, I want to respect that, sir.
What can I do for you?
I just want to make sure I'm not on your land.
Are you?
Am I on public land?
What are you doing?
From my understanding, I'm on public land.
What are you doing?
I think I'm sitting in a truck on public land.
Don't play games with me,
friend. Why?
You just don't want to. You're on my land. What do you want?
Like, I'm just sitting here. I didn't know I was on your land. I thought I was on public land.
Really?
Just sitting here. Do you want me to move down that ways, or?
Yeah, sure. Why don't you move right over to that road there?
Yeah. I didn't realize I was on your land. I respect that, sir. Alrighty. Yeah, that was a little fucking weird. I wonder what he's gonna do if I don't leave. I mean, he seems like the type of person that probably would, I don't know, man, maybe he'd sick a dog on me, maybe he'd do something to the old truck there, maybe he's gonna follow me all the way. I don't know what his plan is to do. But I'm not about to mess with him too much because I don't wanna have my truck damaged at all. But we're gonna make our ways out of here as nice and easy. Nice and easy. But yeah, I'm pretty sure I am not on this guy's land. I'm just like on like a public easement here. It's like next to like a baseball diamond, and there's like some other buildings and whatnot, and then yeah, there's like the orange line all around here, like where it looks like sort of a fenced in, blocked in area, but there's no way that this is this guy's property. And let's get his license plate, just to be sure here. We gotta zoom in and get his license plate. What's the license plate there? His license plate there, we'll probably get the shot, I guess. I'm not really sure how to go up there. I guess I'll go up this ways, I guess. Ways I came in. So yeah, he's got a truck. And he drives the security perimeter for them. I guess that guy, I think he's the property owner. That's what my guess would be, that he might be the property owner. And I think I know who that is. I think I've got some intel on that. And so that would be very odd that somebody in, rural town like out here in Richmond, Saskatchewan, that they would be allowing people to live in an abandoned elementary school that they purchased for the purpose of headquartering a cult that broadcasts on Telegram in an effort to take people's money, basically. And I wonder what the folks out here think. I mean, I don't know how long they've been here. I think it's been at least 2-3 days. But I wonder from the folks out here in Richmond, Saskatchewan, what do you think about your new visitords? The visitards. What do you think about your visitards here? Wonder if they're gonna call police, or do they call like a special kind of police? Do they got like alien spaceship police or something? I know it sounds like I'm talking crazy. Like, I'm the one who's fucking crazy, right? But you can do a little bit of research about Romana Didulo and this whole little weird cult thing that's been going on here. And you'll probably find out that I am not the crazy one and that this shit is all true. There is a lady in this school here who believes that she is the Queen of Canada. This is the guy that owns the school. And, we're just gonna howdy doody. How's she going, bud? We're just gonna give him, we just drive on by and give him a how's she going, bud, you know? but I'm not really leaving. I'm just going to be monitoring the activities and the activitords and the activitards of the local cultificationes. He told me to go on the road up here. This called railway or something like that. Just find the baseball diamond in Richmond, Saskatchewan. But yeah, of course, gonna keep the truck on, keep the doors locked. That guy looked big mad that I found the freaking headquarters. He looked real big mad about that. So that, you know, that could result in maybe a guy being a bit butthurt when you find the secret headquarters of the cult that he probably knows deep down that the guy probably knows deep down he's mad because he's probably mad at himself that he fell into this type of thing. Maybe he's mad at, you know, society because the stuff is messed up right now. You know, the economy's messed up. You know, we got all these natural disasters and fires and wars, and yeah, maybe he got the mental health thing going on a little bit. And there's, you know, there's, I can't, oh, real rickshaw road out here. You know, but I can't, you know, can't hate a guy on something like that. You know, if he's got the mental healths, you really just can't hate a guy. Oh, here he comes again. He's coming in his truck once again, to come up on here. I'm just going to try and drive right by him here. Oh, hey, how's she going, bud? How's she going?
Good. When you see that rope across there?
Yeah.
I'm 10 feet towards you.
What do you mean?
That rope, my property.
Oh, okay, yeah, I got you.
Yeah.
Totally respect that, sir.
No problem.
Not trying to offend or anything.
No problem, man. You have a good
day. Yep. He said, you see that orange rope? Well, my shit is 10 feet from that property there. This guy out here with the excavator doing work. Hear the beep, beep, beep from the excavator. So yeah, I might talk to some folks out here. See if, it looks like there's a sort of a crew that might be working in the area here. So I might have to ask them about the goings on in Richmond, Saskatchewan. You know, is shit weird? Is shit weird out here? QAnon proof? That Romana Didulo is involved with QAnon stuff? Oh, yeah, no, those were two separate things I was talking about. I think maybe with the, if you're getting the Million March confused, that's not related. But, QAnon, Crystal McCoy, yeah, just, I don't know, do a Google search for, Romana Didulo. Maybe go on her Telegram page there. It's like Telegram is an app you can get. It's like a little airplane on a blue square on the iPhone app store. And yeah, you could find the Romana Didulo groups there. The one that I have been getting some tips from as of recent is called the Victims of Romana Didulo. And yeah. You know, the victims, they speak out. They say, you know, we lost a lot of money. Some people lost RVs. Some people spent a lot of money keeping those RVs running and fixing them. Some people, you know, missed out on time with family, traveling around the country with her, thinking that this is some kind of a, you know, next generation, new wave sort of thing. Maybe they think the laws are all changing, or, you know, it's probably a lot of different ways to try and explain it, but sadly, I think it really has to do with the pressures of society, a little bit of that mental health issues, and people just being a little bit desperate and wanting to find a solution. I mean, that's how most scams work, folks. If you know how a scam works, a lot of the time it works with, you know, takes advantage of some type of either a greed. You know, if you have a greed and they call you up and they say, hey, it's the sweepstakes and you've won. You know, it's the publisher's clearinghouse sweepstakes and you've won, ma'am, sir, you have won $720,000 on the sweepstakes. Okay. And now all you've got to do is pay the taxes on that. We just need you to send a envelope full of cache with tinfoil wrapped around it somewhere in California so they can fence that and then mule it over to India somehow. That's what happens with your money, by the way, when you wrap it up in tinfoil and put it in the mail. Yeah, gets passed around from mule to mule to mule until it's basically untraceable, and then it's sent to a foreign country, and you'll never see your money again. A lot of these scams, you know, there's all kinds of scams. The Publishers Clearinghouse is one that I heard recently was going around southern Alberta. They're calling up old elderly people, you know, people 70 plus, probably in that age category. They kind of gauge by the phone call. They hear the person's voice on the other end, and they go, okay, I think I got somebody that sounds old. And they say, okay, you know, you've won Publishers Clearinghouse. You know, they're going to have a foreign accent. But, I mean, people are getting used to that nowadays where, you know, you call TELUS or Shaw or any 1-800 number, and you're probably going to get somebody with an accent, you know, like that. So, you know, people are just getting sort of used to it. But there's lots of scams. If you know any of these scams, if you've been looking out for them, warn somebody in your family who is maybe who's older. You know, if you've got some older family members that you don't talk to too often, when you do touch base with them, make it part of the normal conversation to talk to them about the scams that are going on. And you got to identify the new stuff that's going on. There's like, okay, just going to name a couple. Fake Amazon order return scam. So they call you up, they say, you've ordered something on Amazon. If this is a mistake, let us know. And they go, oh, I don't order anything on Amazon. So they press one, this is a mistake. They get a voice on the line. It says, hey, we're going to refund you your money. We just need some account information, right? And you know where that goes, obviously. You know, there's the McAfee and the Windows scammers. They call you up pretending to be either Google or antivirus or Microsoft Windows. They call you up and they scam you. Usually what they'll do is they'll get app on your computer where they can actually see what you're doing, control what you're doing, and then they'll get you to log into your bank. So if anybody ever asks you to install AnyDesk, sometimes you'll hear them refer to it as AnyDesk. When they say it, the scam artists, they say it like AnyDesk. But AnyDesk, if somebody asks you over the phone to install that on your computer, it is a bad idea. Very bad idea. Do not put those things on your computer. Hey man, I agree with you, the scams of the elderly, vulnerable people, but not putting down March for children, not the government. Please look into this. You need to stick up for vulnerable children. I certainly do stick up for vulnerable children. I just think that this is it's an overreaction by a really extreme religious dude. I mean, do you know the guy that started this thing? Have you seen any of the videos from the two organizers of this thing? The one who is a quote-unquote doctor, okay, just has a PhD in engineering, all right? So we're not talking medical doctor, all right? Dr. Bahriani or something like that. Bahriani's something like that. Anyways, not a physical doctor. You know, somebody who went to school for engineering. You know, the other guy, what's his name? El-Sheikh. What's his, Kamel El-Sheikh, the main guy I don't know, there must be 50-50. They both call themselves the main organizer, you know, but, they've said this morning, they said yesterday that they're not marching anymore. It's not a march anymore, so the hashtag kind of doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but, you know, I guess you could call it Million March for Children and then just not march. One says take the kids out of school. The other one says drop the kids off at school and then come to the protest. You know, they're saying that they think there's going to be people dressed in all black that are going to show up to counter protest, and they're going to have masks on and stuff. It's like, that just seems like outlandish. I just really don't think that there's going to be people with black masks on. I mean, from what it looks like, what it sounds like, the biggest opponent to the Million March for Children is like LGBTQ communities, 2S plus communities all across Canada. That they're just sort of like, hey, this hatred and anger that you folks are experiencing seems to be directed towards a already marginalized group. And like, I don't know, it just seems like some of the rhetoric there is just like, I don't know, let's like take away some of the rights of these children. I mean, if you really do want to protect children, then shouldn't you want to give them all of their rights? you know, not wait until they're 18 and then just give them rights, you know? So if it's wait until they're 18 and then give them rights, all right, okay. I mean, I just don't think that you gotta be 18 to get your human rights. Probably should be able to get your human rights as soon as you're a human in just about all cases. But yeah, the kids in school, they got rights. And, you know, if that right is to want to protect themselves by letting somebody at school know about something that they're experiencing, you know, gender identity wise, and they feel that if they were to express that at home, that there would be, you know, some kind of retribution against them, or if that would be a dangerous place to do that, I mean, doesn't it make sense to have the option available there for them to talk to somebody at school that they feel safe with? You know, so, I mean, I guess if your perspective is that, you know, they're just, kids are not safe at all in schools, then obviously what I'm saying is not going to ring true to you. You're going to say, no, well, they're not safe going to talk to the teachers about that, because that's not something for the teachers to talk to them about. And it's like, I got you. All right. So, you know, next step. I mean, if the next step is a big, big march, all righty. We'll see what happens. I will be attending in Medicine Hat at the Baseball Diamond to take some interviews, talk to some folks, see what they're feeling, you know, see what's going on, all that kind of thing. Yeah, I was going to head over there. I'm going to stop the live for a little bit. I'm going to head over there. I'm going to talk to the folks that are working the construction here to see if they've got any comments on what's going on with Romana Didulo. And yeah, you can put as many comments as you want in the comments section. Super apologize if I offended any snowflakes by not being totally down with the million march. I just think it's just look into it a little more, right? I mean, if just superficially you're like, I want to go because I want to stick up for kids. It's like, totally. I mean, yeah, if that's all it was, but I don't think that's all it is. I think there's a little more to it. And if you just want to scratch superficially on stuff and just, you know, believe what the very superficial surface says, then that's cool too. I'm the type that likes to deep dive and dig right in. And when I dug into that one, something stank. So, you know, I just had to let you guys know what I found out. And, you know, what I found out was that the two people who, you know, started the thing are quite obviously very, you know, religious, almost to the level of extremist. That's what I would say. I mean, anybody who thinks, you know, living in Canada that, you know, people should wear hijab, I don't know. It's just like, I mean, I'm not trying to denigrate anybody's religion, but I just don't think that that's like, that's not just like a value that I think is like, you know, something worth putting on kids. I mean, like, if you think like, oh, like it's so terrible to teach kids about like sexuality or whatnot, then I guess the other flip side of the coin is like some people think it's like really terrible to teach kids about religion real early. And I mean, parents have every right to do that, you know, but you know, the kids also got the decisions they make later on in life. I think if you, you know, what I've experienced since I've moved out to Alberta is that if you repress the kids with all kinds of religious stuff, they end up kind of like going far opposite. Like it's like the pendulum swings, you know, and you push that pendulum too far towards a religious extreme, then you know, in their coming of age, maybe teens, 20s, early adulthood, they you know, they tend to move into some stuff that's maybe a little bit extreme on the other end, you know, sex and drugs and stuff like that. So I don't know, that's just what I've seen, my personal opinion. Like to share that with you while I give you facts and tell you what's going on. But yeah, like I said, gonna have a little cruise around and see if there's any folks that I can talk to about this, get any interviews locally here. So yeah, send me messages, send me comments. Jumping all over the place too much. Yeah, Laura, that's what I do early in the mornings when I haven't had too much sleep. I've had a lot of coffee. But yeah, thanks for watching, folks. I will be back again a little later on, probably on live. But we'll also be doing some work with the camera there to document what's going on out here in Richmound, Saskatchewan. Thanks again, folks, for tuning in. Talk to you soon.